Welcome to our channel. In this video, we are going to talk about history of Atlas robot. So before starting, please like this video, and subscribe to our channel for future updates. Atlas is built to handle some of the most dangerous and high-stakes missions imaginable, such as responding to a nuclear reactor during a meltdown, shutting down a deep water oil leak, or assisting in the extinguishment of a blazing wildfire. And if Atlas succeeds at such daring feats, one of its offspring may one day be permitted to perform something as important: assist in the care of the aged and infirm. Atlas was unveiled on Thursday at Boston Dynamics, a company based in Waltham, Massachusetts, that has already developed an impressive collection of robotic beasts, some with funding from the Department of Defense, including a headless robot pack mule called LS3, a gecko-like wall-climbing bot called Rise, and a four-legged machine called Cheetah capable of bounding along at 29 miles per hour. Atlas, like many previous machines, is a legged machine with remarkable powers. The 6-foot-tall, 330-pound robot has 28 degrees of freedom, thanks to powerful hydraulically driven joints that enable it to not only carry large objects but also respond to a loss of balance with surprising rapidity. A lidar, a laser-ranging sensor on the robot's helmet, gives it a comprehensive 3D map of its surroundings. It also features two pairs of robotic hands that are slightly different. The robot now requires a tether to provide cooling water and high-voltage power, but an untethered version is planned for 2014. Atlas did robotic exercises to demonstrate its flexibility at Thursday's event, which was a little noisy due to the trembling movement of its hydraulic muscles. In simulations, prototypes were seen walking over uneven ground and inching along small ledges. Several Atlas robots, as well as a few other robots, are competing in the DARPA Robotics Challenge, which aims to develop a robot that can be controlled remotely in dangerous, complex emergency circumstances. Two groups of teams from academia and industry are competing. One is designing and building robots for such missions, while the other is developing rescue robot control software. DARPA will give each of the 7 teams competing in the ladder track in Atlas to help them refine their programming. The teams that have signed up for the challenge will spend the next few months preparing their robots to compete in a physically demanding competition that will test their capacity to accomplish tasks that would be difficult for most people. The robots will attempt to complete a robot obstacle course featuring obstacles such as stepping inside and driving a vehicle, clambering over rubble, and attaching and operating a hose at an event held at the Homestead Miami Speedway in December. Even though Atlas resembles an early Terminator prototype, DARPA says that the robot is exclusively intended for humanitarian missions and is not designed for adversarial military activities. The Fukushima nuclear disaster in 2011, when human personnel struggled to run a nuclear plant badly damaged by an earthquake and tsunami, inspired the agency's robotics challenge, according to the agency. DARPA did send few-wheeled robots to the Fukushima plant, but they couldn't deal with impediments like rubble on the ground or do the intricate duties that were required. At Thursday's launch, DARPA program manager Gil Pratt stated, "We were ripping our hair out trying to help, and the truth is there was very little we could do." Humanoid robots have been buzzing about robotics research labs for decades, and have long been a staple of science fiction. However, they were usually too sluggish, feeble, or awkward to do much. Recent advancements in sensors and hardware have pushed the idea of a real-world-ready humanoid closer. Pratt pointed to the hydraulic controls, the lidar navigation system incorporated into the robot's head, and the robot's interchangeable hands as examples of technology that have gotten just good enough, or almost good enough, to make this thing work. "It's a remarkable machine," said Seth Teller, an MIT professor who, together with colleague Russ Tedrick, leads one of the organizations chosen to receive an Atlas. "They did an amazing job with these computers. Seeing, touching, and using the original hardware was a wonderful treat." The teams allocated Atlas robots will have to develop control software that will allow human controllers to run the robots despite considerable time delays, a constraint designed to imitate the difficulty of operating from inside the crumbling walls of a nuclear power station or from a great distance. Teller's team used an approach in which the human operator broke down each high-level mission into a series of smaller jobs and guided the robot through each task. "Present teleoperation methods place an excessive amount of cognitive strain on the operator. Finding a means to command these robots that decreases that load is one of the major aspects of the DARPA challenge," Teller added. When asked what kinds of advances Atlas could spur outside of emergency response, he suggested that humanoid robots could one day work in healthcare. "I know this robot looks huge, and I know it weighs 300 pounds," he continued, "but the number one usage for devices like this will be in home care and healthcare. The next generation of Atlas." Boston Dynamics published a video of a new version of the Atlas robot on YouTube on February 23, 2016. Atlas is now available in a new version that may be used both outside and inside buildings. It is designed for mobile manipulation and is capable of walking through a variety of terrain, including snow, as well as performing backflips and cartwheels. It is hydraulically actuated and electrically driven. It balances itself with sensors in its body and legs, and it employs LIDAR and stereo sensors in its head to avoid obstructions, assesses the environment, aid navigation, and control items, even when they're moving. Atlas stands 150 centimeters, 4 feet 11 in, tall and weighs 80 kilograms in this edition, 180 pounds. Jumping across the grass on uneven terrain and jumping over a log lying on the grass in this video. On October 12, 2018, Boston Dynamics uploaded a new Atlas robot update video to YouTube. Atlas was seen rushing around and jumping over crates in this video. On September 24, 2019, Boston Dynamics uploaded a new Atlas robot update video to YouTube. Atlas was seen in this video doing something like a gymnastics floor routine. The robot shows off his abilities to do a handstand, somersaults and spins in quick succession. The robot was taught using new methodologies that streamline the development process, according to Boston Dynamics. On December 29, 2020, Boston Dynamics produced a music video showing two Atlas robots, a spot robot, and a handle robot dancing to the song, "Do You Love Me?" Boston Dynamics posted a video of two Atlas robots completing a parkour course featuring leaps, balance beams, and vaults on August 17, 2021. Atlas is 5 feet tall, 1.5 meters, and weighs 190 pounds, according to another video broadcast the same day, 85 kilograms. Atlas is a 20 degree of freedom battery-powered and hydraulically operated robot. Its control system receives data from RGB cameras and depth sensors. Three onboard processors handle all of the calculations required for control perception and estimate. On July 11, 2013, Atlas was introduced to the public. The robot's debut was described as a big, though unsteady, step toward the long-anticipated age of humanoid robots by the New York Times, who called it a remarkable example of how computers are beginning to sprout legs and walk around in the physical world. A new species, Robo Sapiens, is forming, said Gary Bradsky, an artificial intelligence expert. What do you think of our video? Let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoy this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go and also press the bell icon so that you can get notification about our new videos. If it was helpful, then share it with others. Thanks for watching the video.